Hello everyone, this is Vicki Verley, the Rock and Roll Prophetess, and today we're going to take a look at the new moon in Aquarius, which is occurring on January 30th of 2014. Now, the new moon is at, here's the sun and the moon conjunct in Aquarius, at 10 degrees. Now, if you've been watching some of my videos and or even just watching the planets, you realize that 10 degrees has been a key thing this whole, the whole year of 2013. It's been like, you know, there's been a lot of times where we've had these lineups, including the Uranus-Pluto square that was going on, was at 10 degrees. And there's been a lot of things at this 10-degree mark every time we seem to look at these charts. So here it is again, new moon in Aquarius. But I feel like by the time we get to Aquarius, we've come a long way since Aries. You know, we've come a long way when we get to Aquarius. So maybe, and Aquarius is about enlightenment and understanding. So I feel that, you know, even though we're in a new year and everything's new, I feel this is very much like kind of wrapping up the end of 2013 and some of the issues, and looking at it from an Aquarian point of view, you know, a more enlightened point of view, a little bit of a detached emotionally. You know, it's more reason, it's more in your head and not in your heart. And I know everybody's trying to do the heart thing now, and, you know, and that's where we're all heading, but this is, sometimes you do have to look at it this way, because sometimes when you're too much in your heart about issues, you know, you just can't see the forest, you can't see the forest for the trees, you don't see clearly because your emotions can cloud, your judgment, and that's a very true thing. And I think that's, it's been a very emotional with the Pluto this whole year, and all this gut-wrenching stuff, and then the nodes have been traveling through, you know, Scorpio, and there's been all this deep Pluto, Scorpio, Capricorn, you know, deep stuff. And speaking of that, before we get too deep into this, you know, what I always like to do is, like, look at the chart, just kind of look and see what's happening. So the first thing I see is the Jupiter beaming all the lights, but talking about degree numbers, there's a lot of high degrees again in this chart. You know, we've got Ceres at 29, we've got Vesta at 26, we've got Lilith at 26, we've got Mercury at 29, you know, so these are the tail ends. These are the tail ends of all this old stuff. We're going to go back again. And you know that the last new moon, right on January 1st, was by our Western New Year. And this, I think the next day, this is January 30th, I believe it's the next day, or right around the same time, we're going to have the Chinese New Year. I actually, you know, it's, I wrote a children's song, I'll put a link below, Happy New Year, and I wanted to feature New Year's from all over the world. And when I went to research it, it's amazing that it's almost every month it's New Year somewhere. You know, but in China, and a lot of the Asian cultures too, we have this, the first new, this new moon is always going to be the new year. But I will put a link to that song. It's pretty amazing. Somewhere around the world, almost on every month, it's a new year somewhere. So I will put that in there. But it's interesting because the last new moon was on a new year. And these are the two biggies that everybody knows. Of course, January 1st. And lots of people know about Chinese New Year, too, because they follow the, maybe follow the Chinese astrology. So, you know, the year of, I should have looked it up. That's not irrelevant. But it's just, it's like there's a newness. And then it's just like the very entrails of the old is we're going to be done with it. And I want to look at some of these planets that are in these high degrees here. So we have Ceres and Vesta, again with nurturing and everything. Lilith, maybe the mean woman, but the woman who stands up for herself, or the underdog who stands up for themselves, is more what I'm getting for Lilith. Like, I'm not just going to let this, no, I'm going to say something. The emperor has no clothes. You know, I think Lilith is calling out the emperor. Like, the dude's got no clothes, man. You know, it's it's like Lilith is going to call you out. That's more what I feel about Lilith. And so maybe she does have to be a little aggressive to do that, but she's going to do it. And then Mercury at 29. In Aquarius, so here's the Aquarian energy again. 29 is always that last little tip of the sign, the last, we're really finishing things up when we get to 29. And it's the circle of life, you know, because once you get to 29, of course, what happens next? You start over at zero, you know, so that's always going on. That's the cycles of life. But 29 Mercury. So Mercury, what you say, what you did. Maybe if you did run off at the mouth on New Year's or say something you regret over the holidays, because there was a lot of turbulent stuff happening then. You know, maybe this is the time to finally, you know, get over, somebody said something to you, get over it, or make amends, or maybe it's Aquarius energy again. We're letting it go. Because Aquarius is darn grudge holders. You know, they don't even, it's like in one ear and out the next. They're too busy, you know, looking forward into space to, you know, Scorpios, you know, they hold those grudges. Pluto. Yeah, so those are the kind of energies that'll hold a grudge. But Aquarian, not so much. They don't get their feathers ruffled easily. Aquarians don't. You know, that's the whole thing. So Mercury, you know, Mercury in Aquarius, you know, regardless of this past stuff, you know, that's, you know, again, that inventive energy. And it's, you know, with the Pallas is also making a lot of aspects too. And Pallas gives me that, you know, inventive, there's at that 10 degree mark. It's one of the planets at the 10 degree mark here. So we've got at the other opposition to Pallas, while we're still over here in this neighborhood, we've got the Chiron-Juno conjunction, opposed Pallas. So, and then, you know, Jupiter, it's in there with Jupiter too, trining Jupiter. So I feel a lot of ease about this. I feel a lot of ease about this. And even though we've got the sextile to Pluto-Venus over here too, coming from here, you know, I just feel ease about it. Because, you know, Chiron is deep stuff, man. It's hurtful. It's deep, heart-wrenching. And Juno's, I feel, is bringing that light energy, as I said in the last video. But Jupiter, too. And this is like nurturing feelings. This is all watery stuff. This is your emotions. You can. I think a healing could happen, or you could get an understanding about it. Or you could take a kinder approach with Juno. Because sometimes, I heard this great thing. It's hurt people. So people who are hurt other people. And that's that kind of like that Chiron energy. So Juno, maybe it's going to be like, yeah, I've been hurt, but I'm not going to lash out and hurt somebody else. I'm going to let it enhance my compassion for others or empathy for others rather than you know, going to that deeper, darker place. You know, I think that could help this. That could be a helper thing. And nurture, you know, Cancer, I want to nurture, I want to help you. I want to mother you, I want to heal you. You know, those kind of energies are happening there. So I feel real good about this. You know, I feel like this is some positive energy. Jupiter, again, display of all the energy to Jupiter, also squaring Uranus. But I think, too, it's just like the more positive aspect of Uranus. And Uranus, of course, rules Aquarius, where the new moon is occurring. You know, the more positive, lightening up. I just feel the energies are lightening up now. It's been so deep, dark, and heavy. And I just feel it's moving into like a more lighthearted place. Jupiter also is in direct opposition with the Pluto-Venus conjunction that's happening here. So that's almost kind of the same energy in a way, you know, the Juno to the Chiron, you know, the love energy to the dark energy is Venus, love energy to the dark energy of Pluto. Venus is being retrograding too, so we did hit, you know, we did go back, and Venus does make you go back in emotions, and it does make you think about old wounds and things like that with this Pluto stuff. We're really getting in there. We're really going deep. And holidays bring up, you know, we just got through the holidays. Holidays bring up all sorts of crazy emotions and people and all sorts of crazy memories and things like that. And Capricorn is old and elder. You know, one of the things it rules over. But Venus is getting ready to go direct. Yeah, I think it's real soon. It's within a few days too, or quickly after that. So Venus is going to go direct pretty soon after this moment in time here. And we've got the new moon. So again, this is brightening up. Venus direct is, you know, Venus in Capricorn already, I don't know if it's officially at its detriment, but it's not very expressed well there. And then retrograde too, it's even more, you know, being, you know, squashed or squelched or something. So Venus going direct, I like that. Pluto's there to give it its send-off. You know, Pluto's like, okay, kid, it's been nice spending time with you. Here you go. And it's going to give it this powerful send-off, like they've reconciled with each other. Or hopefully we have. We've reconciled with some things or within Venus relationships. You know, it also could be some money stuff too, big time, because Pluto is big money, Venus is money. Capricorn is, you know, the outward world, buildings, real estate, old school stuff. On these kind of days, again, I don't do the stock market, but when that Venus goes direct, that'd be a good time for maybe for some old time stocks to something good to happen with them, you know, Capricorn type of stocks, male, old time, male paradigm, money, investment firms, you know, old banks, you know, but it's like old money. Old, you know, stable companies. So there could be some kind of positive shift there happening when this goes direct. I'll have to look it up. I think it's within a day or so. It's really, really soon after. So that's something that could be like a very positive thing. So, you know, again, overall positive. Another thing that's happening about getting out of these deep, dark energies, not yet, but it's going to be coming up, and I looked, it's in February. So we're going to get more into this. But these nodes have been in here. Have been in this Taurus and Scorpio energy, and we're down to 2 degrees. So as the nodes, you know, retrograde, and most of the time they're mostly moving backwards. Next, they're going to be moving into Libra. It's going to be Libra Aries. So again, these are partnerships, but more fun and more lighthearted. You know, Aries is me, and Libra is we. The other thing that's going to happen with these points here and these higher degrees, these are going to intercept. I should, you know, it's going to happen here within, before we do the next thing, because this is moving forward and this is moving backwards. So these are going to hit. There's going to be a conjunction of the North Node to Ceres, to Vesta, and to Mars. So that's going to be powerful. The North Node, and the nodes are powerful. Their past life and future vision. It's your path in life. It's your soul contract, your soul mission. Your nodes, your north node talks about your soul mission, why you came here, what you're doing here. The south node is like your past life, and it's very heavy duty esoteric energy. The nodes are, and you know, with that Saturn thing, that was we have the Saturn in both in Scorpio. That's heavy too. That's karmic too. But these are gonna hit. So I think we're not done with some of these issues, which Ceres is, you know, the goddess of the grain. So I always go back to the food. I think we're not done with the food. And the North Node is like, we're going to take the high road. We're going to do the right thing. And Scorpio says, well, we've dug in there, baby. We've gotten through. You know, we've dug in there. There's no more fluffing it over. There's no more putting blinders on. There's no more sticking your head in the sand. You know, you've got to take... Scorpio wasn't going to allow that. But... I think while it moves into Libra, we've exposed it. We've dug it up. Scorpio, we've dug it up, okay? Now, Libra, they're better handling it, things. Because you know, Libra can handle things in a nice way. Negotiations can be, you know, agreements can be reached when Libra energy prevails. People will be kinder to each other. Libra is the scales of justice, but it's the scales being balanced, too. So maybe legal things could happen, you know, laws, legislation, but also we're coming into more balance, you know, more harmony, more balance, more Venus energy, because Venus is the ruler of Libra. So, you know, we can work it out. Libra wants to find balance. Libra wants to work it out. Libra wants justice to be done, you know, but we don't have to do it in this... way of the Scorpio Taurus, which is a little harsher, you know, in this Pluto and Aries energy, you know. So this is going to give a nice vibe to things. And also with this nodes, those of us that are old enough, you know, nodes travel in roughly 20-year cycles. I think it's 18 to 20-year cycles. So as we move this final glimpse or this final blast of this little breath of energy of these nodes. You know, you think back to that time of 20 years ago. What were the lessons then? Is there a similarity to what was going on 20 years ago and what's been going on here in recent years? Because these lessons will come back and cycle around. And some of them are people, but some of them are not the same people, but the same circumstances, you know. So you might want to reflect on that. This is 29s, and then this node's getting ready to change signs. This is a time to reflect, like, how far have I come? is there a similar situation? What was going on 20 years ago, you know, if you're old enough to remember that, or, you know, and how is it similar? How did I handle it better this time, or did I? Did I handle it better, or did I, have I not moved, you know, one iota since 20 years ago? Have I not grown at all or changed at all? Because Pluto with, and the Scorpio energy, you know, that is change. It's death and rebirth. Pluto comes through your chart, you're never going to be the same again. You know, that's how that works. And that's that, you know, you can, it'll, you know, it'll nudge you first, but if you don't get it, you know, Pluto can really be some harsh energy. It can really make you, bring you to your knees. You know, Capricorn rules the knees. Pluto and Capricorn. Okay. So I don't know. Is that about it? What else is going on here? Anything else we want to take a look at? Not really. Overall, I just feel lighter energy. You know, a little bit of tail end of finishing up these last few things. But I think, like, the worst is over. You know, I think we've come through the storm. And maybe it's still raining a little with the water energy, but with Jupiter, and you know, I think it's shining. It's new, and with the new moon in Aquarius, again looking forward, looking for new ways to do things. Okay, before I go, I wanted to show you guys. I've been on this creative binge, and I have my affirmation journals that I use. I have notebooks full of affirmations, and it's just, you know, sometimes I don't want to drag it out, and it's just like, oh, I want to sit here and read all these affirmations all the time. It's like, you know, I get kind of lazy where I don't want to do it. So what I started to do, I've started making this art. And the background, this is the original painting in the background. And I have an affirmation. This is a heart-opening one, aptly fitting the My Heart painting. And the main affirmation here is, my heart is opening more and more each day. And I just hang this on my wall so I can just see it all the time. And in lighter tones here, I have words. Positive words, happiness, gratitude, healing, clarity, you know, laughter. And you don't even really have to go through and read all these words. You know, this is like a big time saver too, because, excuse me, you don't have to go through and read all these words. You can just, you know, you can just, and what I do is I just look at the painting really. And sometimes, I know it's out there, but if you guys watch my forecast, you know, you know I'm a little out there anyway. But sometimes when I'm staring at it, these background, stuff starts like moving, you know, kind of just, but really what I just see it all the time. Put it like in your bedroom, or put it in your, maybe in your bathroom would be a good place. And I've set up, I have it in a few different colors, you know, tones. That was the original before, and I have it in sort of a pinkish tone, and then a purplish tone, and then more into the greens and everything. So, you know, what I've done is I've got prints available in my Etsy shop. I have another Etsy shop, VV Creative. I'll put a link below. But if you wanted to order, like, I have the 5x7s available for just $11. And it's really like a time saver, too. And it's like a constant reminder. You just glance over at this, or you could put it in a little frame on your desk or somewhere. And these words, you don't even have to go through read the words. I'm telling you, your subconscious mind is seeing all these words. And it's sinking in, and the painting is kind of magical too. I think the original painting is sort of magical. And like I said, I just look at it, and sometimes I see these beams and these rays in the background sort of like moving around, like energy. You know, if you just kind of stare off, you know, let your gaze relax a little and just sort of stare at it, sometimes I see the things moving around there. So yeah, I thought I'd show it to you. I'm going to actually do more affirmations. I'm clearing out all those notebooks of affirmations, and I'm going to put the main gist of it. But I thought this was a cool one. My heart is opening more and more each day. Even if you just want to just read that and look at it for a minute, you know, and then these words will sink in. Or you could go through and say or think each of these words. But I've been using it, and I'm really liking it. And I think it's like a big time saver, and it's no hassle at all. It's like, oh, I don't want to get that notebook out and sit here and read all these affirmations, you know, or which is not, I know you're supposed to do it. So I came up with this. I think it's pretty cool. It's working for me. If you want to order a print, like I said, there's 5x7s are only $11 in my Etsy shop. I'll leave the link below. Have a happy Chinese New Year. And I think the energies are getting lighter. Thank you so much for commenting, donating. If you want to order a reading from me, you can find the link for that as well below. I've opened up my hours a little more because a lot of people didn't like my limited hours. So I'm going to be more flexible and try to work around your schedule. Have a great new year, and I'll talk to you soon.